Back in the 1960s, cartoons received a lot of flack from parental groups, stating that the shows were too violent on impressionable youngsters. We talked about this a while back. Now, I was exposed to 20 or so years worth of cartoons, from Hanna-Barbera stuff to He-Man, Thundercats, the list goes on. I turned out okay. Anyway, not too long ago, back in 1995, I was reintroduced to some of these classic cartoons courtesy of Cartoon Network. Now, I would spend weekends at Jay's house and we would watch Herculoids, Dino-Mutt the Dog Wonder, what else? Birdman, Mighty Mitor, Galaxy Trio, all this stuff. A lot of the stuff I haven't even seen before, and some of which I just got so excited, like, wow, I haven't seen this since I was a kid. So that's what we're going to spend this episode doing. We're going to take a look at just a few of some of my favorite Hanna-Barbera cartoons. Let's have a look. Just from watching this, you'll instantly think Harvey Birdman. Well, old Harvey had to start somewhere. This is the original Birdman, which aired originally on September 9th, 1967, and ran for about 40 episodes. Each episode runs about 6 to 7 minutes long, and in the series, Birdman is assisted by his eagle sidekick, Avenger. When they receive a mission from Falcon 7, it's off to battle the villain. One of my favorite parts of the series is Birdman's battle cry. I realize that wouldn't hold up in a modern-day cartoon, but for the 1960s, damn, that's awesome. Okay, villains. Not a lot of time to show them all or talk about them all, and I don't really have any particular favorite or least favorite. Birdman usually wipes the floor with them in just a short amount of time. Other characters have appeared throughout the series, like Bird Boy and Bird Girl, though Bird Girl was just created through hypnosis and some super serum, along with a pair of metal wings, similar to how Bird Boy got around. Both characters would later be part of the cast in the Harvey Birdman series decades later. The original Birdman would also air side by side with another 6-minute series called The Galaxy Trio. As you may have guessed, it's a group of three superpowered beings: Vapor Man, Gravity Girl, and Meteor Man. No, this Meteor Man. Now, Vapor Man can transform into a gaseous form, so he can get out of any tight spot, he can fly, and fire different forms of vapor like freeze and a heat vapor. Gravity Girl can fly as well and is able to lift massive objects with only her mind. Meteor Man can make any part of his body big or small, and whatever part he makes bigger becomes stronger. Yeah, I know what kind of jokes that's gonna bring up. Bunch of perverts. Seriously though, if Meteor Man makes his fist bigger, he can punch out any villain. And yes, they do show the impact of the fist hitting the bad guy. Sometimes it could be a robot or something, but I guess a cartoon of this nature would raise some issues with a kid's parents or those parental groups who go around saying that cartoons are evil and violent. Come on, really? How many incidents or even accidents were caused by kids watching frickin' Galaxy Trio? Or any other 60s cartoons for that matter? How many kids were injured? I want numbers. Somebody give me numbers. Now the Galaxy Trio cruise around in their ship, Condor 1, patrolling, well, the galaxy. They'll usually receive a mission from the chief, kind of how Birdman gets his little assignments. The trio face different beings from different planets, and they did so for about 20 episodes. I'm still getting reacquainted with the series, and I got through half of it so far. Now remember, I watched this before in 1995. Some episodes are a blur, some aren't. So yes, I can review this even though I haven't finished watching or rewatching it. Last on my list is Mighty Mitor. This I saved for last because I think I enjoyed this series more growing up. I remember it more because Mitor had a secret identity of a teenage caveman, Tor. He has a magical club that transforms him into Mitor whenever there's trouble. It also transforms his pet dinosaur, Tog, into Tog. Hey, this looks kind of familiar.
By the power of Grayskull!
Mitor? I think you might need to get a lawyer in on this one. I'm just messing around. Although one of the supporting characters is named She-Ra. There's also Little Rock and Chief Pondo. Little Rock always runs around trying to be like Mitor, usually gets him in trouble. This was yet another 6-minute cartoon, and that ran alongside the series Moby Dick, which I never really watched. But all three of these entries are among my favorites to watch again and again. Naturally, there are others, some of which haven't been officially released on VHS or DVD, but as I find them, in whatever form I can get them, we'll take a look at them. Until next time.